We've just organised the stripper for your 40th.
Then I'm not going.
It'll be fun.
I would honestly not go if there was a stripper there. I would be absolutely devastated. I would. I'd find that really disrespectful because it's so...
It's fun though. It's a 40th
it's
though.
It's not something I enjoy. It's not something I like.
It's going to be like...
I don't enjoy it, Danny.
Okay, Winckle.
I don't like it. Okay. I hate it with a passion. Like, okay. I despise them.
Okay, Winckle, we're going to have like... you know how we're having the big fire, the big bonfire?
No.
It's going to be like the fireman comes along and with his big hose to put it out. You know what I'm saying? Just go along with it though. It's your 40th.
No, I don't agree. I don't like it. I don't approve of it. Well, it's not me. Well, I'm not going. Well, I'm honestly not going if that's going to turn up. Because it's so not who I am. It's not something I find fun.
It's a bit of fun.
It's not a bit of fun for me. I don't enjoy it.
A fireman doing a dance.
I don't like it.
Putting out the fire with his hose.
Well, he won't be doing it to me because I'll go into my bedroom. It'll seriously put a massive damper on my
party. You'll have 100 people there at your 40th.
I won't appreciate it. I don't appreciate that stuff.
What, some sexy looking guys dressing around?
I despise it. I don't find guys sexy. So I don't enjoy it. Like some guy throwing his willy at the air. That's shit.
Absolutely gorgeous day in Geelong. I'm just going to put it out there to the universe. I'm becoming fatter and I can't lose weight. So I've made myself a challenge. I'm not going to have a shave until I get to under 80 kilos. At the moment I'm 87 and a half kilos.
Fuck!
So I'm putting it out there. I've got to get to under 80 kilos. I'm not going to shave until then. So anyway. First time we talked, you were out of breath. You told me that I was something else. Not many days have passed since you went into my mind and out.
Hello, Annie.
Hello, Danny.
You look pretty today.
Thank you so much. That does wonders for my self-esteem.
Does it really?
Not really, no.
Are we good? Are we going bankrupt or are we looking good? If we're going bankrupt, please lie for the sake of the camera.
We're doing amazingly. We're raking in the dough.
Yes! Annie, can you say this?
No.
Show me the money. No, just that.
No.
Okay, now just go, show me the money.
No, I'm busy.
Now what about, just quickly go, show me the money.
Show me the money.
Annie, tell me something that no one knows
about.
Can I show
you out of the office? Out that way.
Hi. How's my dog going?
He's not your dog anymore.
Are you looking after him?
He's my dog.
Me and Stace move home in 2 weeks and Lisa has been looking after Sherman.
Sherman and Jackie are friends now.
That's awesome. Is John okay with Sherman?
Yeah.
What are you doing?
I'm going to be frustrated, Jenny, because I'm trying to write an ad and it's not happening.
You've been to acting school before?
No.
Okay. How long is it taking you to write an ad for a property at the moment?
About an hour.
Yeah, okay. So I see agents do this all the time. They spend, they can't cope with, So there should be three parts to an ad. This is just my view.
Mm.
The introduction.
Yep.
God, I don't know.
What's going on
with you today, mate?
What do you mean?
What's the plan? Okay, school's in. I don't really like doing too many of these educational videos, and for some reason I don't like to talk too much on Million Dollar Bogan. Maybe I should talk more, I don't know. Anyway, let's move on. When I was on holidays recently in Fiji, I ran a couple of forums, and on one of the forums, I think a guy had a go at me.
Fucking bullshit!
He said these words, He said, why would you want to have multiple offices, like I have? He said, why would you not just have a super office? Stating that it was just ego and, you know, if your multiple offices aren't that big, you know, and he was making statements that you've got, you know, 4 or 5 time receptionists, you know. He was making the statements that if you're in the same town, like I'm in Geelong, and we have 4 offices and we're about to open up number 5. Geelong's a pretty big town. Just in Geelong itself is 300,000. Then you've got all the outside suburbs, which we sort of cater to as well, to some degree. But he said, Why would you not have one super office where you have, you know, 20 or 30 or 40 agents? Because that way you've only got, you know, one receptionist. You know, your costs are only one, as opposed to maybe diluting your office by having multiple offices, which I think was alluding to what I've done. Because when I owned a super office, when I owned the number one, and I'll just get the trophy to prove it, because there's so much bullshit on social media. I'll just go to the trophy wall, hang on. Property management, you can't see this shit. 10, top. I think you can see it. That one actually says a number one performer at Victoria. Ray White Group. You can't see it anyway. So the question is, do you have a super office? Or do you have multiple offices if you're the owner? And this is a really interesting debate because some people won't get it because they're dumb. Okay. So, and I don't mean to be offensive by this, but first of all, if you own an office, you have to create a super office, I think, if you want to have other offices. I think it is total ego if you just want to open up a second office just to say, I've got two offices and then three offices. So that doesn't make sense to me. That is ego, and that will drain you, that will kill you. So here's the reason why we opened up office number two. Okay, we simply ran out of space. And the reason I've opened up multiple offices, and here's the main bit of meat, and I'm probably giving away some of my trade secrets here, but you know, it's funny, people are so protective of secrets, but what people don't understand is, one is you've got to have stamina. And you've got to have tenacity, and you just can't give up. And most people don't have stamina. They're not tenacious, and they just give up. They quit because it all gets too hard. So I'm not a quitter. So back to the nitty-gritty of the offices. So here's the thing. With a super office, you end up with big black gorillas, or if you don't know what that is, it's gun salespeople that are ambitious as hell, and they're looking for opportunity. And I've definitely had this happen in my business where people have left and they've opened up other offices. And you know, 10 years of business ownership, that's happened to me a fair bit. Okay, I've not had a lot of people leave and go to opposition. I've had people leave and open up other offices. Okay, and I get all of that. People have their own dreams and aspirations. Okay, so when you have a super office, in my opinion, that's gonna happen more because when people get to a certain level, younger guys, 25, 30, 35, they want to potentially go into business ownership, okay? Now, I don't believe this when people say this. When you're a business owner, be prepared to earn less than your staff. If that's your mindset, you're doing it wrong or you're a shit business owner. The point I'm trying to make is, when I opened up this second office, okay, what I did was I actually brought new people into the team and I locked some people in through shareholding, through ownership, okay, and they became directors. Two people. One property management, one owner, okay? Me and Michelle had majority shareholding, so we opened up office number two. Me and Michelle still held majority shareholding, but we weren't the turnkey people. We weren't going there and turning the key and opening it up. And these new directors, they made it their baby under our umbrella, okay? So all of a sudden, we're working in the Heighton office, Michelle and I, and we've got this East Geelong office, which all of a sudden is growing a rent roll. Building. So we've got we've got one rent roll here. So we've got two times happening. And you might say, yeah, but you've got extra expenses now. And that's correct. We've got an extra receptionist. Okay. That was really the only expense. Okay. And also the fit out. And obviously there's other expenses, photocopying and all of that. But that was really the only expense. And what we're doing is we're building a rent roll. We brought new people in. And what I did was the people that bought into the business, I used their money to fund the fit out and to sort of carry the first 3 or 4 months because that would be where the pain is. So we didn't take the money, we used that. So me and Michelle, in essence, got a free spin for a second office, okay? And today, 3 years on, that office has a rent roll of, I think, 240. That rent roll, this second office is worth, the rent roll is approximately worth 1 second. So that second office, 2.5 years on, just the rent roll alone, roughly brings in, well, I won't tell you exactly what it brings in, but I'll tell you what it's worth wholesale. I'm all about wholesaling. I never inflate figures. I'd rather, as a business owner, I'd rather under-inflate. So that rent roll, if I was to sell that rent roll, and rent rolls are very lucrative, that rent roll today, 3 years later, is worth just under $700,000 wholesale, okay? So that's office number two. It's self-sufficient. There's no debt on it. And it's growing, you know, and we've still got the Heighton office, the central hub. Michelle and I, still based at Heighton, we thought we've got this East Geelong, We want to buy commercial property. We thought it's a good investment for our future. So we thought, why don't we have a central hub in Newtown? So we found a commercial property and we bought it. It's not perfect, but it's very central and, you know, I'm in it now. So what we did was we got someone to buy in, another team member. So we locked them in. So when someone's locked in, they're locked in for life. They're an owner, you know. And it's such a different mindset when you're an owner, when you get to call yourself a director. So we locked this person in, and this person's locked in the rent roll. So they run the rent roll and they manage the rent roll. What happened was we had someone that lived on the ballot who is young and ambitious, who's been my PA before. She came to me wanting to explore opening up an office. And so we did a deal. So she's an owner there. Michelle and I, again, are the main owners of that office. She's the turnkey person. So we have office number 4 opened up. So part of her funds where she bought in is me and Michelle use that to fit out the office and renovate and some running costs for the first few months. So that's the 4 offices. Now, what's happened is I've allowed people within the Hayes Winckle group to fulfill their own dreams and aspirations within our group using our brand, which is awesome. Me and Michelle still retain control. And what's happened is it has diluted that initial super office a bit, okay? But I'll tell you this, so much shit spruiked all over the internet and everyone's a fucking expert on real estate, okay? But I think what I bring to the table, what I try to bring to the table is a level of I'm doing it in real time and this is authentic. What I'm sharing about is real. I'm in the trenches today, 4 offices looking at opening number 5, talking about business ownership. And that's my passion. It's not listing and selling, it's growing a business. Okay. What I'm trying to say is this, we live in a world where it's all about instant gratification. I want it now, I want it now, I want it now. You have to build your empire and it's gonna take time. And what I've done is I've got the 4 offices opening up 5 offices. And sometimes it's a little bit brittle and this one's not going too well and this one's going well and it all chops and changes, yeah? But slowly, if you just add 1 person to each team and get them off a retainer, it grows. They all grow and they all grow. And I've got 4 rent rolls all growing at once at the moment. And I've got 2 new people joining me that are opening up our new Lara office. And so it lifts again. So the team pushes to 35 full-timers. And the whole thing lifts. My job is to keep it all together. And you might say, well, but you've diluted your super office. It's not about a super office. It's about growing an empire. You can't grow an empire from a super office. You just can't. Because what will happen is people will leave you. They eventually leave. I've had it happen. It's what happens. You want to keep growing a super office, people will leave, okay? People are going to leave anyway in business ownership, but you've got to try and mitigate that to some level. So what I've done is I sort of have taken less of sharing the journey because I'm a sharer. It's not all about Danny Hayes or Michelle Winckle. We share it with other people. But here's the good thing. Here's the good thing about this. If you're smart, I have Annie, okay? And this is a beautiful thing. Annie does all the back end. She does all the settlements. She does all the financials, she does all the pays, she does all the tax, she does all the super of all the offices, okay? These are all separate offices, they're all separate companies, okay? So 4 offices at the moment, 8 companies. So each office has a sales company and a rental company, okay? So the reason you should have that is because if you want to sell a percentage of the rent roll, it's easy to do. It's just easy to do, okay? So I have 8 companies set up. Okay, there's all a sales component and a rental component. So it makes it easy to sell for people to buy in or buy out. What I'm trying to say, so Annie works at Newtown, so her wage is divided by 4 offices. It's just that simple. So the overheads become less and less, okay? And once an office gets to about 50 to 60 rentals, where it can cover the receptionist's wage and the property manager's wage and cover the rent, you're starting to get into the light. It's starting to get easier. And once you get to 100 rentals, 120, you'd almost start to, the rent roll starts to cover everything. Once you get to 200 rentals, it's ginger beer and Jesus. You get 6 offices, you get to divide it by 6. You get 10 offices, you get to divide it by 10. That means that people come into business with you are gonna make more profit because you're not just setting up 1 office. And even if you do have the super office, I'm not knocking having a super office, right? This is just my opinion and my viewpoint. And it's certainly not perfect. It's just the way I see business through my filter, through the way I've lived my life. This is how I'm doing it. But even with a super office, you're eventually gonna need 2 receptionists. You need double anyway. So, you know, I would rather, I can nurture 1 tomato plant, but I could have another 20 tomato plants, but I could get another 20 people to nurture that tomato plant. I could guide them to nurture that tomato plant. I stopped looking after the one here so intently because I have a director there already. And then I have another plant carer over here and I give them some guidance each week and give them some guidance each week and we all live together. You know what I'm saying? So I think that's a better way to understand it. Something I didn't say, I actually had to cut the dialogue out. Something really important to say is that... Fuck, I forgot what it is. It was really important.